Hey everybody, what's going on? My name is Derek Mitchell, and in this video, we're going to take a look at the brand new Adobe Fresco app on the iPad. I'm going to show you how to bring in some artwork, trace over the top of it, sketch it out, paint it with oil color and watercolor brushes, which are amazing, by the way. It's going to be a ton of fun, and it's meant to be kind of an introductory review of the app, but also a tutorial on how to get in and get sketching rather than just showing you every bell and whistle. So we're not going to go into every key feature of the application. We're just going to dive in and get your feet wet and let you start having fun with it right away. Today's video is sponsored by the Graphic Design Bootcamp. If you're looking at becoming a graphic designer and you want to learn more about Photoshop, Illustrator, and InDesign, creating real-world projects that clients would actually pay you for things like logos, business cards, letterhead, and much more, check out the link below for more information and a deep discount to get started today. All right, let's go ahead and dive in. So first things first, this original artwork actually came from somebody else here at the Inktober. If you go to instagram.com/Inktober, you can find this sketch here. I thought it was a ton of fun and I wanted to use it for this lesson. So special shout out to Jake Parker, I believe is his name, the original artist. And right here, Jake Parker, the creator of the Inktober challenge, which has been a ton of fun. So what we're gonna do today is I'm just gonna grab this photo. I'm just gonna go ahead and click on the volume up button and this other side button here to take a screen grab. We'll click on that. I'm just gonna crop it in real quick. And once I get that where I want it, I'm gonna go ahead and click up here in this top right for the share button. And I'm going to, down here, we're gonna scroll down and I'm going to save it to files. I'm just gonna save it to, we'll just throw it on my iPad right now. And I'm gonna click up here to make a new folder. I'm just gonna call this Fresco because I have a feeling that this won't be the first time that I do this. So we'll click done. We've got a new folder in my iPad called Fresco. So we're just going to click on that and hit save to throw this this photo down in there. Now I'm going to go ahead and switch over to Fresco here. And first things first, since this is a brand new app, let's go ahead and take a look at the home screen real quick. So by default, it's going to look like this, and it's got the light theme. And if you're familiar with Procreate at all, you probably prefer the dark theme. I know that everything that I do on my Mac and using the Adobe Creative Suite, I like the dark theme as well. So I'm going to go ahead and change that real quick first. So we'll click up here on the gear on the top right, and it's the first thing we see under general is the interface. I'm going to change the color scheme to dark, just because I like how it looks better. And then the other thing you might want to change, if I come down here to input, by default, it's going to say show color picker. So if you've got an Apple Pencil, and I like to hold mine with the flat spot right here, so I can just double tap with my finger to switch between the pen or the eraser. So in the Fresco app, though, that's going to default to the color picker. So what we're going to do under input, we're going to come down to switch to eraser. So that way I need to erase things. I can just double click real quick and erase as I'm working. So those are the settings that I found as I've been using this app that have been a lot of help for me to get going. And then the next thing that I would do is I'm just going to create a new document. So whatever size you want, if you're going to be posting Instagram, maybe you want to go square. I've just been playing with the my size, which makes it the same size as the iPad that I'm currently using. All right, so first thing we need to do is go ahead and grab that photo, that screen grab that we just did. And down the left-hand side, we can see our tools. And almost halfway, we've got the little photo icon. There's a lot of different ways that we can bring in different layers, whether it's a PSD file from the Creative Cloud, or in this case, I'm going to jump into my files. And I'm going to click up here in the top left to go back to locations and switch from what's on my iCloud drive down to what is on my iPad. And now we can see that new Fresco folder that I made. And I'll go ahead and click on that PNG image and it'll throw it right on my canvas. You'll notice over here on the side, I've got my layers and it threw it right on the top stack. But before I can do anything, you'll notice the tools are gone and I've got these transform controls. So if I wanted to, now's the time where you can scale it up using your fingers, using the Apple Pencil, whatever you want to do to get it where you want it to be. And then when it's all said and done, come up here on the top right, we'll click done to apply that transformation. And I want to go ahead and start drawing on this. But before I get started, what I'm going to do up here, I'm going to click on this little menu item here for the layer. It's basically our layer properties window. And we can change the blend mode and do a lot of other fun stuff. But what I want to do right now is just scrub this opacity down just a little bit, just to kind of barely see it, but just enough to work as a guide as I'm drawing. So we'll go ahead and close that window. We'll tap once on the layer. You can tap there or you can tap down here on these three dots to get to the same thing. But what we want to do is actually lock that layer. So come down here and I'll click on lock layer. And now there'll be a lock icon. So that way I'm not drawing on this layer. And we had the original blank layer that we started with. I can just click and drag to move this up above, or I could click the little plus in the box here to add a new layer above that as well. So now this is the fun part, right? This is the stuff we're about to get into that is really cool and what separates the Adobe Fresco app from everything else. So we've got these three brushes up here. We've got a pixel brush, we've got our live brush, and then we have our vector brushes. But really the bread and butter right now is the most fun. This is all new and exciting. If we click and hold, we've got our live brushes. So what I'm gonna do is go ahead and click the watercolor brush, and then we have four different choices by default. And depending on how much you use the app and what you find are your favorites, be sure to tap this favorite, the star, so that way as you're working, it's easier to switch back and forth between brushes. So for the sake of showing you the new fun features, I'm just gonna grab some color here, and we'll change our brush size. We've got our flow, and then how much water. So right now I'm gonna crank the water flow way up just to show you this feature. As I scribble on here, and let's switch to something much more obvious, a darker color. As I color, you'll notice that this behaves a lot like a watercolor. And then I've got this button down here, it's been kind of hiding, but what that does is it switches from now painting with the brush color to just painting with water. So I'm basically adding water to the canvas as I do that. I can double tap to lock that on, or double tap to move it, or click and drag to move it to other parts of the canvas if I want to. So this is gonna be a ton of fun. This is gonna come in handy down the road as we get going on this project. I'm gonna go ahead and tap once on this layer, and I'm going to delete the layer. We'll add a new one on top just to start clean. And we're gonna switch from the watercolor brush to a pixel brush. And there are a lot of great options in here. And you can add even more brushes and Photoshop brushes. That's gonna be beyond the scope of this video today. If you wanna see some of that, be sure to comment below in the video if you want me to create more lessons around Adobe Fresco. But let's go ahead and stay focused here so I don't get off on a tangent. What I'm gonna do under the pixel brushes, we're gonna come right down to the basic brushes. And this hard round variable brush is a great place to start. There's obviously a lot of other great places as well. But what I'm trying to do is create the outlines for this sketch. So I don't really want the opacity to be variable. I just want the size to be variable. So I'll tap on that, tap outside here. And with the brush selected, these are our options to modify that brush. So we've got our color, we've got our size, we've got our flow, our smoothness, and then down here some more brush settings, and you can actually draw in this window to sample to see if it's gonna fit your needs. So one thing that I noticed right away is if I wanna do some really fine lining in here, it doesn't get small enough for me, so I'm gonna come down here to Shape Dynamics, and my size jitter is set to 0%, but it's set with the pressure control here. My minimum diameter is 57% of the brush width. So if I push really hard, it'll get thicker, but it won't get any smaller than 50% of that. So if I crunch this down a little bit, now I'll be able to have really fine lines, but push harder to get those thicker lines if I want to. So it just is a personal preference, whatever you want to work with, but that's how you would modify that. We come down to this menu and modify the shape dynamics, and then that minimum diameter. That's how that changed. So just something to be aware of. All right, now we can get after it and start having fun. So what we're gonna do is just pick anywhere you wanna start, and we're just gonna start outlining. And I'm gonna go ahead and pause this video because you get the point for this. All right, so for the sake of speeding up this tutorial, what I'm gonna do is actually clone one of these that I've already sketched out completely. But one thing I wanna point out is when you're on the home screen, you don't have a secondary menu, or at least not one that I see yet, to clone or to even delete these documents. So what you need to do is come down here under the Your Work tab and click on the Cloud Documents, and then you'll get these little three dots next to your drawing. And from there, you can duplicate, you can export these, you can make them available offline, and you can even delete the file if you don't want it on your iPad anymore. So what I'm gonna do is go ahead and click on Duplicate to create a copy of this artwork here, and then I'm gonna open it back up. So that way you can just kind of see my workflow. Basically what I did is we kept the outline layer. Let's go ahead and turn that on and off. We'll just toggle this visibility. So you can see we kept the outlines on top and then just painted underneath it. So what I'm gonna do is let's go ahead and just delete these layers real quick. And now we're ready to color this. So what I'm gonna do is add a new layer, and making sure that this new layer is below my outline file here. And we're just gonna grab any color, it doesn't really matter, but you can grab using the color wheel here to really dial in the exact color you want to work with. And then as far as brushes go, for the coloring part, just to kind of show this off, I'm going to go back to the watercolor brush just because it's a lot of fun to work with. And the other one too, the oil brush, is also a ton of fun. And again, a little bit beyond the scope of this lesson right now, but we're going to play with it for just a second. So you can see as I work with different colors and the oil, it really blends and looks amazing. So the oil brush is another way that we might want to use to color this as well. The other thing I would point out with the oil brush down here under the settings is reload color. So every time you tap off of the canvas, it reloads to that fresh color you're working with. Otherwise, what happens if you turn that off and we start coloring in here, the ink from wherever you're tapping your brush gets loaded into your brush and blends, just like if it was really an oil painting, which is really cool and definitely a lot of fun to play with. So what I'm going to do, now that I've made a mess of this, I'm going to go ahead and delete this layer again. We'll start fresh. And you know what? I might actually just paint with oil on this. It could be a lot of fun. So let's change our brush size here. And we're going to brighten this up just a little bit. And now comes the fun part where you just get to color. Coloring is honestly one of my favorite things to do. Sketching's fun too, but I don't know. Coloring is a nice way to let my mind wander here. All right, so now that we've got the base color down, what we're going to do is actually create a new layer just above the one we were working with, and I'm going to switch to a different pixel brush to kind of burn the edges here just to kind of add some depth. And the reason why I'm doing this instead of painting on the same layer, what I was going to do originally was paint on the same layer with a darker color, and it would be fun. It would be cool because you get to play with the way that the oil brushes work together. And I've got it set right now to reload color every time I pick it up. So every time I pick up my brush and tap again, it comes back with this dark color. If I leave it down, then it starts to blend with the color around it. And it's a ton of fun. It's a lot of fun, actually. And it's really amazing how well it works. But the problem I'm going to run into is that it's going to take a ton of work to get this the shade the way that I want it to. So what I'm going to do, just tapping with two fingers to undo there. I'm going to come back to this layer above, and I'm going to switch to a pixel brush. And let's go ahead and do hard round opacity. So what that's going to do is it's going to stay round, it's going to stay the same size, but depending on how hard I push, it'll become more opaque or transparent. So now what I can do with that brush selected, let's just kind of see size-wise, it's pretty big. So now if I gently push, you're not going to see hardly anything, but if I push harder, you'll see, you know, what it's doing here. I'm going to come back and let's go ahead and turn on. So we've got the shape dynamics. I'm going to turn on the size jitter as well. I'm going to change it from none to pen pressure. So both the pen pressure for the size as well as the opacity. So that way I can kind of color in smaller if I want to, or come in thicker. So we'll see how this works for us here. The other thing I'm going to do is actually turn my flow down. It's already down to 20%. Let's go down to 15. And now I can just kind of start playing here. And as I'm using this, I think that it's going to be more difficult to control it with that size jitter on. So I'm going to turn that back off. Let's come back into shape dynamics, size jitter. I'm going to turn that off. And that way it'll just be the opacity that's fading in and out. So one last change here. We're just going to save this, or bring the size down a little bit, and now we can get to work. All right, so basically what I'm trying to do is just tint or shade any of the spots that would be in shadow. So we'll go ahead and fast forward this a little bit, but you get the idea. So now what I'm going to do, working on this layer that's above our color layer, I'm just going to start adding some shadow to everything here. All right, and that's pretty much it for our shading. So now what I want to do is go ahead and add the little white here to the suction cup. So I'm going to add another layer above it. I'm going to switch our brush to a white brush. Oops, There we go, white. And let's go ahead and check out our other settings here. Turn our flow all the way up. We'll come down to our transfer and the opacity jitter. We're going to turn off the pen pressure. We'll turn it to none. And now I can come in here. We're going to need to change one more thing here. Shape dynamics, size jitter. We'll put that back on pen pressure. So now we can color real finely or make it larger. I'm going to put the minimum diameter up a little bit. And that should get us pretty close. And I forgot to make a new layer, so we're going to step back. Make sure we're painting on top of our shadow layer just in case we need to make some changes. Now in this case, I made a little bit of a mistake. I went a little too far out. So I'm going to double tap on my eraser here and just kind of clean that up a little bit. So I'm actually erasing white from this layer. And, you know, obviously I made a lot of other mistakes here too. We're bleeding past some things, but I'm just trying to go fast. Let's see how that's looking. That looks pretty good. That's fun. Awesome. So we're going to go ahead and speed things up even faster here. So now you get a good idea of how to work with the brushes, how to bring something in and color over the top of it. But what if you want to get this out of the box and share it with somebody else? Up here in the top, we've got this little share icon. So I'm going to tap on that. And we have a few different ways that we can publish this and export it. So the first is publish and export. So if I click on this, it's going to give us a few more options. And one that's a lot of fun is this time-lapse export. So if I tap on that, it's going to give me a play button where I can play it and preview back the work that I did to see what it looks like. And then if I like it, I can click on the export button here and I can either send it to somebody else or I can save the video right here down to my save it down to my iPad, and that'll be in my photo roll. Or I can click export as, and there's a few different formats here. We've got a PNG, a JPEG, Photoshop PSD file, or a PDF. You can also control the quality. Now again, this is actually something I didn't say before, but this is dependent on the fact that you actually have a Creative Cloud subscription and you have Photoshop and all the other tools, or you're gonna have to subscribe. At the time of this recording, I think you get 6 months for free, and then after that, it's 10 bucks a month for the app. So that being said, depending on the subscription level you're on, you might see some different export options here. But that's essentially how you would get this out. Just click up here. We can also do a quick export where you share a snapshot and you can save the image as well down to your photo gallery or share it with a friend. So that's pretty much it for the new Adobe Fresco app. I hope you enjoyed that. I hope that gives you some ideas as well as other ways that you can work beyond just sketching in here. I hope that tip as far as bringing in other photos to paint over the top of helps you think of some creative ways to use this. And again, special thank you to Jake for letting me borrow / steal his artwork to bring this in to show you guys. That was a ton of fun, and I think this is a really cool piece that he did, and hope you guys learned a ton. All right, guys, this teaching style is brand new for me. I've never done an iPad screen grab, and it was a little bit weird to get started trying to get the angles right with the camera so there wasn't reflections and stuff like that. So give me some grace. Let me know if you like it, though, if it's something I should keep doing and get better at. I had a ton of fun and really enjoyed getting to give you guys some tips on how to use Adobe Fresco, as well as just drawing is something that I've always loved and I just don't get to do enough of it. So definitely looking forward to making more of these videos. So comment below what you want to see next and stay tuned for more. I publish new videos every Wednesday and Friday. So we'll see you next time.